Thousands crammed in the streets of Kabul. It was always going to be a race to safety.
Given the situation, which I've got to stress, is terribly dangerous outside the airport.
Overnight, four flights conducted by the Australian Defence Force, more than 300 people airlifted out, taken to this temporary camp in the Middle East.
Is this a place for them to rest? And to be looked after and make sure they feel safe.
A safe haven for a few days before travelling on to Australia.
These people are coming from a really traumatic situation. I've served in Afghanistan, so have seen firsthand how bad it can get.
The US rescued almost 4,000 people across 38 flights, but now wants citizens and those fleeing to stay away from the airport amid fears of a security threat.
They are going to make decisions in real time about what's in the best interest of innocent civilians.
The Australian government's intelligence is that anyone trying to get out should still go to the airport.
And that's the constant communication we've had wherever we can have that communication.
Australia shut its embassy in Afghanistan back in May of this year. Since April, 430 Afghan locals who have been engaged by the Australian government have been brought home to Australia, but countless remain and many won't be rescued.
I can't guarantee the situation in Afghanistan.
The Afghan-Australian community and their supporters gathered in Brisbane today, calling on our leaders to do all they can to help. Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.